Symphonic Band's spring concert, Road Trip. If you haven't met me, my name is Corey Smith, and this afternoon it is my honor to be your tour guide as we go on the circumnavigational musical tour of America. I encourage you to scan that QR code that's inside your programs to learn more about the composers and more about the pieces than I will be sharing with you. So every good road trip is going to start off with us filling our gas tank. So after we take our tuning note, we are going to begin by driving south down to the redwood forests of California. Composer Nicole Piunno's piece, Postcard from Sequoia, paints a picture of these magnificent trees, some that are over 3,000 years old and over 300 feet tall. These big trees don't leave that much room for sunlight to get through, but if sunlight does break through the canopy, it just seems to kind of dance around. So you'll hear both the beauty and the grandeur of the height and the circumference of these trees, and you'll hear that dance theme too. So after we tune, we hope you enjoy Postcard from Sequoia.
Thank you.
make up San Antonio Mission National Park. It is now, recently, dedicated as a World Heritage Site. So the composer, Charlie Hill, mirrored the concept of these five missions into this work that has five continuous sections in it. And the sections depict the history of this period in time. So you'll hear the arrival of the Spanish monks into this desolate area that we know as Southern Texas. We'll hear the worship of the missions with very beautiful, like, church music type of chorale stuff with gorgeous chimes. We, of course, have to have a fiesta because life is going well until the arrival of the Mexican army and the Battle of the Alamo. I don't think you'll miss that part. And we'll conclude with a song of peace where we are today. So we hope you enjoy this historic rendition of Charlie Hill's The Missions.
Thank you.
It's a take on a few. Now this time, last year, at our all-new Bard and Blue concert, we opened with a Bach fugue. He's one of the kings of the fugue. And it was very traditional, very serious, very gorgeous. And it was a great way to introduce every single section. Brant Karrick's piece, Bayou Breakdown, that you're about to hear, is a little more of an ambitious and rambunctious take on the fugue. You're going to hear what we call breaks, or the breakdown part, which are solos and solis that are passed throughout the band. Sometimes they overlap, sometimes they're in high instruments and low instruments, sometimes through the magic of composition they all work in tandem, but it is intense and awesome and exciting. And so we hope you enjoy this Cajun party we're about to throw down. This is Brant Karrick's Bayou Breakdown.
Thank you.
I'm really proud of them for that. All right, back into tour guide mode. We are now going to head north to the Shenandoah Valley, and most of us are familiar with the popular folk song, Shenandoah. It's been set by countless composers, probably because the melody is so beautiful, everyone wants to put their own stamp on this beautiful medley. Our arrangement is by Frank Ticheli, one of the legends in our own field, and he penned this arrangement specifically to reflect the beauty of the river and the grand nature of the valley. So you'll hear the river theme throughout in a couple different ways, with like rolling quarter notes that are passed throughout the band. You'll hear like some ebb and flow of some waves coming in and out. And you'll hear the melody go through several different treatments with various different instruments playing. You'll hear a flute trill, you'll hear a clarinet augmentation, which is the fancy word for they're going to stretch the melody twice as slow. If you listen real closely in one of our more glorious moments, Frank Ticheli weaves in the melody of another very common Americana tune, so we'll see if anyone catches that. We hope you enjoy Shenandoah.
Thank you.
Heading northeast, we arrive in the Big Apple, New York City, New York, the birthplace of George and Ira Gershwin, famous songwriting duo who defined decades of popular music in America, from their Tin Pan Alley days to their stages on Broadway to the silver screen of Hollywood, just about every performance venue in between. They have a really cool, extensive website you can check out in the digital QR code, by the way. You'll hear several hits in this medley, from Fascinating Rhythm to Embraceable You, Somebody Loves Me, Someone to Watch Over Me, and then Naturally, I Got Rhythm. Maybe we should change it to We Got Rhythm. After this piece, we'll take our first 10-minute pit stop, or intermission, which is a perfect opportunity for a restroom break. They're in the main lobby. Take a left outside that door. If you want to stand stretch, explore that QR code, say hi to a band member. Any of those things are great ways to spend your time. I'm pointing to the horn of plenty to remind myself. I'll talk about that in a sec, but you can check that out as well. Please enjoy Warren Barker's arrangement of Gershwin.
Thank you.
westward. Our next stop is Detroit, Michigan. Specifically, we are headed to Hitsville, U.S.A., which is the name of the studio that brought America Motown under the specific vision of Berry Gordy. So I heard Motown music described as part street corner symphony, part storefront gospel church, part jazz joint on a Saturday night. And I think that's honestly probably the best description I have for it. It's so much fun. Makes total sense to me. This is one of my favorite genres to listen to when I go on my own road trips. So we hope you enjoy this retro nostalgic medley, Hitsville, USA. Bonus points if any of you get up and start dancing. It is totally welcome. Singing also encouraged.
Thank you.
dramatic and beautiful portrait of South Dakota, but you'll hear a lot of very enigmatic music that kind of we lump into the general Western region, whether it's been through cinema or through TV shows. There's just some very familiar sounds that you'd be like, yeah, I can picture the West in this. It's a rhapsody, and rhapsodies are really neat compositions because they're single movement works and they contain little musical vignettes. And sometimes these different vignettes will flow logically into and out of each other, and sometimes they're just a little bit shocking of one mood, one character, immediately into the next mood and character. So that's something you can have fun listening for. Sometimes it's really logical, like the East River region that this piece is written about. Sometimes it's being startled because there's a cow in the middle of the road. So we hope you enjoy the different vignettes of the Greater West. This is Mark Camphouse's A Dakota Rhapsody.
Thank you.
Washington. This is the Choose Your Own Adventure part of the concert. We're going to perform John Philip Sousa's march called Homeward Bound. While you soak up the classic Sousa-isms that you have become very familiar with and you know and you love, you get to imagine your own route. Maybe you're just going to go straight across Montana for a couple days. Maybe you dip down to Wyoming and head to Vegas. Maybe you go rogue and go north to Canada. But your route probably depends on your budget. So speaking of budget, the Highline Community Symphonic Band is a nonprofit organization sustained by local and regional grants. So thank you to King County for the Arts. Thank you to Burien Arts Commission. And thank you, our patrons, for supporting us both with your attendance and your presence tonight and through any patronage that you may have contributed tonight. We have our Horn of Plenty for nice traditional donations that involve paper. If you are a little more 2024 and want to donate online, you can do so through our website. And we are very, very grateful for any help you can give to help with our operational costs, from purchasing new music to renting performance facilities, any equipment that we need to move instruments. It all is very, very helpful. Everyone behind me is a volunteer. They give up hours of their week to come together and make music. And so can we have just a special round of gratitude for the band? I know how precious time is, and that it means a lot that they give up Monday nights to do this. So thank you. So as you're feeling warm fuzzies about the wonderful people behind me, and you're scanning that QR code to maybe donate, or you're imagining your route home, this is John Philip Sousa's Homeward Bound. Underground, deep underground, to one of the most unique aspects aspects of our region, the fact that we live on two tectonic plates, that at any time when one subducts or moves under the other, could cause some tiny issues like tsunamis and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. Don't you feel comfortable? You're gonna hear a couple different things. You're gonna hear this tectonic plate theme in the low brass as they're like swelling and oozing in and out. That's the plates being subtle and moving, letting us know that something is coming. You're gonna hear a lot of very intense rhythmic backgrounds from the higher woodwinds. That's the intensity and the tension that something is coming. And you're also gonna hear a lot of really beautiful lines, because despite the fact that there is some destruction caused by tectonic plate action, that's also the reason that our landscape is as gorgeous as it is, why we have peaks and valleys and beautiful oceans and everything. So there is some beauty intentionally woven into this piece. We hope you enjoy Tectonic Plates. Usually when I'm packing and doing laundry, that I wish I was still on vacation. So perhaps maybe there's a possibility that you wish we had one more song? We do have a not-so-subtle encore that we were confident enough we'd put into the program. But it's called Coast to Coast, and it starts on the east, goes to the west, and hits some very popular, well-known hits from different states, some of which we visited already, some of which are new. Again, you're invited to sing and dance, as you so please, but thank you for sticking around. This is Coast to Coast. Thank you. Northwest sports team, and we're going to be sharing the stage with Mount Rainier High School. It's going to be wonderful. Safe travels home, and have a wonderful spring. Thank you again.